Now let us study about the fundamental laws of radioactivity. These are some laws to understand. A radioactivity developed on the basis of experiments performed by Rutherford and Soddy. These laws are basically the outcome of the experiments which were performed on various radioactive elements. We'll just conclude with the statement of these laws. The very first point about radioactivity is, radioactivity is purely a nuclear phenomena. It is not concerned with the extranuclear part of an atom. We know that in an atom there is a nucleus and an electron cloud in its surrounding, in which various electrons are there in a specified electronic configuration for every element. So about radioactivity we can write, it is purely a nuclear phenomena. It will not make any difference whether the electronic configuration changes or remains same. So for all isotopes of an element where nuclear structure remains similar, the radioactive phenomena may also be similar, depending on the proton and neutron ratio that we'll study in detail in the coming section. And next point we can write, radioactivity is independent of electronic configuration of an element. Like we can here further clarify, this is somehow related to point number one only, that in different isotopes the chemical properties of radioactive and non-radioactive isotopes remains same, because we know isotopes are those elements in which number of protons remains same. If number of protons are same, number of electrons will also remain same, like what I was talking about explaining when I was explaining point number one. So electronic configuration remains same, so their chemical properties will remain same. But there are some isotopes which are radioactive and some are non-radioactive isotopes, which depend on the neutron-proton ratio in the element. So you must be careful about it. And point number three, here we can write that radioactivity is a random process. That is, out of several nuclei in a sample, which will disintegrate first is just a matter of chance. We cannot directly define which nucleus will disintegrate first and which will disintegrate second in a group of nuclei. This is purely a random process. It can only be studied with the help of laws of probability, but there is no exact way by which we can define in absolute manner how the radioactive process goes on. Fourth point is somehow related to the third one only, that in a radioactive sample, due to randomness, disintegration density remain constant. That means out of several atoms, if we take n group of different atoms, then in each group, the ratio of number of parent nuclei to daughter nuclei will remain same, or the rate of disintegration, the whole group will remain same. Or we can write disintegration density as disintegration per second per unit volume will remain constant no matter how large or small the sample is taken. So you must be careful about these four fundamental statements, which are known as fundamental laws, to understand radioactivity. From next section onward, we'll study about mathematical analysis of radioactivity in a radioactive sample.